Welcome to the Lifestyle Medicine Update. I'm Dr. James Machino. I wanted to bring your attention to an important group of food-based nutrients that demonstrate really important anti-cancer properties. Now, these nutrients are known as protease inhibitors. That might be a new word for you. There's a very powerful and well-researched protease inhibitor found in soybeans and soy products of all kinds, known as the Bowman-Burke protease inhibitor. Now, recent studies show that many other beans and peas also contain protease inhibitors, which we think also inhibit important steps in cancer development. Now, protease inhibitors are known to combat cancer by preventing the synthesis of key proteins required for cancer cells to divide and invade neighboring tissues and organs. They've also been shown to block the initiation of the cancer process and to destroy pre-malignant cells. Now, the Bowman-Burke inhibitor, found in soybeans and soy products, has shown remarkable results in this regard when tested against numerous types of human cancer cell lines and in many animal-based cancer model studies. Now, remarkably, the Bowman-Burke inhibitor does not interfere with the function and replication of normal healthy cells. In other words, it helps destroy cancer cells and precancerous cells, but it leaves normal healthy cells alone. And this is a very unique feature. It's selective, destroying only cancer cells, leaving the healthy cells of the body alone. I mean, it's hard to make drugs that can do that. The question has been whether or not legumes, other than soybeans, contain appreciable amounts of protease inhibitors that have an ability to inhibit cancer development and growth. So a study published in the Journal of Nutrition and Cancer in 2012 gave us some really good insight into this. So the study showed that protease inhibitors found in chickpeas, also known as garbanzo beans, significantly inhibited the viability of certain breast cancer cells. So it helps to destroy those breast cancer cells, as well as both androgen and androgen-independent prostate cancer cells at very reasonable concentrations, so the dose didn't have to be that high. Now, in addition, kidney bean, soybean, and mung bean protease inhibitors inhibited the growth of certain types of prostate cancer cells in the same study. The researchers concluded that these findings suggest that protease inhibitors from chickpeas, kidney beans, and mung beans may possess similar anti-cancer properties that we've seen in the soybean-based Bowman-Burke protease inhibitor. In my view, chickpeas, kidney beans, and other legumes are already known to play an important role in regulating blood sugar, lowering cholesterol, providing health-promoting fiber to the large bowel, and supplying some extra protein to the diet. You know, in much of the Western world, we've moved away from the consumption of beans and peas. They're not typically a main staple of the modern diet. Now, one of the things that you can do to enhance your health status on many levels is to replace starchy foods like bread, pasta, rice, potatoes, with beans and peas on a regular basis. You know, if you look at health data from other countries where beans and peas are a main feature of the diet, as well as the experimental research that exists, it suggests that one additional way to reduce your risk of certain types of breast, prostate, colon, and other cancers is to include more beans and peas in your daily diet. This dietary adjustment would also help to reduce risk of heart disease, prevent and help better manage diabetes and high blood sugar problems, and improve weight management. So I've included the scientific reference for this study in the text below. I'd love you to think about ways you can start including more beans and peas in your own diet. It's a very important consideration for your long-term health. Okay, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.